Balancing nuclear equations is an important skill, just like balancing ordinary chemical equations is. In nuclear chemistry, you know that we have certain elements, certain isotopes that are unstable and can emit particles. And that phenomenon we refer to as radioactivity. And the common particles that we'll be dealing with are the alpha particle. Here I've symbolized it. The lowercase number is 2. That means 2 protons. The uppercase number 4. There must be 2 neutrons there as well. 2 protons and 2 neutrons. A beta particle is like an electron. Negative charge and 0 protons and neutrons. The neutron, you're well familiar with its characteristics. One atomic mass unit up here. And a positron is like, a positive electron. You could think of it that way. Rather than a minus 1, it has a plus 1 down here. Still 0 atomic mass units. Alpha, beta, and gamma is one that you've heard of too. But gamma is really electromagnetic radiation. Technically not a particle. Let's look at a typical nuclear equation. In a nuclear reaction, the elements change. That's very different from what we had in ordinary circumstances. When we were balancing an ordinary chemical reaction, if we had calcium on the left, we needed to have calcium on the right. But here we've got uranium, element 92, and it's changing into element 90, thorium. When we balance a nuclear equation, the lowercase numbers on the left, the sum of those numbers, must equal the sum of the lowercase numbers over on the right. So we have 92 protons on the left, we've got to have 92 over on the right. And so we've got that lowercase number 2. And it's also true of the uppercase numbers. 238 protons and neutrons on the left, we've got to have 238 over there. Thorium has 234. That means that we must have 4 on this particle. And so this is an example of alpha emission. So balancing nuclear equations is not tough. Just keep in mind those simple rules. Here's another nuclear equation, and I've left out something this time. A particle is being emitted. Let's see if we can figure out what the missing particle is. And I might add that anytime you're given a nuclear equation, one of the skills that we'd like you to have is to be able to balance that equation. And so if we left out the particle, we could leave this out or this out or this out. If we give you all the other pieces of information, we'd like you to be able to fill in the missing information. So in this case, thorium has continued to disintegrate. It's giving off a particle. It's undergoing this phenomenon of radioactivity. And we notice 234 protons and neutrons over on the right, 234 on the left. And so this uppercase number is going to be 0. 90 and 91, well, we can make 90 on each side if we have a minus 1 over there. And then remembering your table of particles, this corresponds with a beta particle, an electron in essence. So here's an example of beta emission. Down here's another nuclear process, starting with an iron isotope. Once in a while, it's possible for a nucleus to capture an orbiting electron. And when that occurs, in essence, a proton combines with the electron and changes into a neutron. And in doing so, we get a new element. In this case, iron is changing into manganese. Let's see if we can come up with the characteristics of this isotope. Well, we could find manganese on the table of the periodic table of elements and see that it's element 25. Or we could calculate that, 26 and a minus 1. We know that we're going to have 25 protons over there. 55 and 0, This is manganese 55. Let's look at another type of nuclear process. Sometimes it's possible to bombard an isotope with a particle and cause a nuclear transformation. This is referred to as induced radioactivity. So here I've got a boron isotope. We're colliding it with an alpha particle. Sum of the uppercase numbers here on the left is 14. Over here we get a nitrogen isotope plus a neutron. Uppercase numbers 14. The lowercase numbers 7, 7 and 0, it balances. Here's another example of an induced radioactive process. I think this was carried out by Madame Curie. Starting with an aluminum isotope, ending up with phosphorus, giving off a neutron. Let's see if we can figure out what phosphorus isotope it is. 13 and 2, well, this lowercase number must be 15. And hopefully, if we look on the periodic chart, phosphorus is element 15. The uppercase numbers total to 31 on the left. Here, this must be phosphorus 30. So that 30 plus 1 gives us the same number that we have on the left.